Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about preparation of competent E. coli cell and bacterial transformation. Chemical transformation mainly depend on high-scald calcium chloride treatment where cell become competent, and second is the heat shock treatment where cell uptakes the exogenous DNA. Here, during the heat shock transformation, uses calcium chloride rich environment to provide calcium chloride to counteract electrostatic repulsion between the plasmid DNA and bacterial cell membrane. Sudden increase in the temperature creates pore in the plasma membrane of the bacteria, and that allow for plasmid DNA to enter inside the cell when it is given temperature of about 42 degree centigrade for 2 minutes. This will allow the plasmid DNA to enter inside the bacterial cell, through which transformation takes place, through which the transformed cells will be produced. Now, competent cell preparation procedure. Here, first the sterile append of tube, which is of 1.5 ml, will be taken and it will be labeled. Then from the mid log bacterial suspension, transform 1 ml of the culture into the sterile 1.5 ml tube. Place the tube in microcentrifuge and spin for 2 minutes at 10,000 rpm. After that, sterilely drain off the LB broth, leaving a visible pellet of bacteria in the tube. Then use this use a sterile plastic pipette to transfer 1.5 ml of calcium chloride to the tube containing cells. After that, resuspend the pelleted cell by vigorous vortexing the tube, then place on ice for 20 minutes. Later on, after 20 minutes, place this tube in a centrifuge, then spin for 2 minutes at 10,000 rpm. Then sterilely drain off the calcium chloride carefully, not to disturb the cell pellet. Then again add 2 drops of fresh calcium chloride and vortex to resuspend. Then place the cells suspended in the calcium chloride on ice in refrigerator, which should be like 0 degree centigrade. The approximate temperature should be around 0 degree centigrade. Then store until you are ready to use them. Do not freeze this. Okay, the sample should not be freezed. Then hold the cell at 0 degree for 24 hours. Increase the cell competency. Then cell can be held on a wet ice. It could be like a combination of melted or a solid ice for several days while you are making a recombinant construct. Now, the steps which are involved in transformation of competent cells. First, we have to take the competent cell at 4 degree centigrade in a append of tube. To this, we have to add 100 nanogram of plasmid DNA. Then move to the water bath. That append of tube is taken to the water bath at and we have to keep it in the water bath at 42 degrees centigrade for 45 seconds. Then we have to add growth medium immediately. Grow at 37 degrees centigrade for 1 hour. See, at this temperature, heat shock treatment, that plasmid DNA will enter inside the competent cell. After that heat treatment, like after 45 seconds in 42 degrees centigrade, then immediately the culture was removed and to this growth medium will be added, and then allow this culture to grow at 37 degrees for 1 hour. Then we have to plate these cells on a culture plate. On this plate, if colonies are produced, both transformants and non-transformants will be present in the culture plate. Plating the culture on the culture plate, this plate consists of a antibiotic, like whatever the plasmid usually will have an antibiotic resistance gene also. So the transformants cannot able to grow in that selective medium. Whereas the non-transformants could not able to grow in that selective medium. But if you are growing it on a normal medium, both transformants and non-transformants will be grown on that. But if we are going to grow this cells immediately into the plate which is having a selective media, then only the transformants will be produced. So in this way, we are going to screen the transformant from the plate. Conclusion: non-commercial preparation should give 10 to the power of 6 to 10 to the power of 7 transformant per microgram of plasmid. A poor preparation will be about 10 to the power of 4 per microgram or less. But a good preparation of a competent cells give up to 10 to the power of 10 colonies per microgram of plasmid. Protocols, however, exist for making super competent cells that may yield a transformation efficiency of over 10 to the power of 9. The chemical method, however, usually does not work well for linear DNA, such as fragment of chromosomal DNA, probably because cells' native exogenous enzymes rapidly degrade linear DNA. In contrast, cells that are naturally competent are usually transformed more efficiently with linear DNA than with the plasmid DNA. The transformation efficiency using the calcium chloride method decreases with plasmid size. Now, what are the precautions we have to take while doing the transformation work or even preparing a competent cells? The calcium chloride is a hazardous material for skin, eyes and respiratory system and may cause burns. Hence, use gloves while using them. Then avoid thawing of cell before use, and even keep cell on ice not longer than 3 hours. Do not use cells again that have been on ice. Then you can freeze the competent cells in liquid nitrogen. The stock freezing might keep cell viable for a long period, but it decreases the transformation efficiency by at least a factor of 10. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.